Awesome. Can you all hear me okay?
Yes.
Those leadership skills that you develop and show.
Create a stellar internship experience for the, as you saw, 4,400 and something interns. So time, document the experiences that you're having and the people that you're meeting with.
And then I was in that role for a few years, and then eventually we restructured, and then I got put into a role leading an engineering team.
The mouse, the keyboards, the manufacturing of Xbox, HoloLens, I'm responsible for all of that on the devices side, but I'm also responsible for Windows and those collective businesses.
I wanted to echo Brandon's comment about communication.
Another big piece that we do for the ERG is our language preservation.
To this day, I look back and I check in and, you know, work to see if those mentors or inspirations are proud of what I'm doing, because I know that means I'm on the right path.
Across gaming and across like platforms will be decided by content. How do you get the most content and how do you have the most access to content?
You know, to me, the future of gaming is actually going to be in the hands of, you know, what we like to call citizen creators. And it's been in the past that only the largest studios could make games, but increasingly the tools are out there.
So there is somebody meant specifically to look at, you know, understand the producting, where we only allow certain customers to come into the beta and test things in a controlled environment.
Let's get started. So Waldy, what did you enjoy most about the BAM New York Summer Mentorship Program?
What I enjoyed the most is the fact that we got the opportunity to meet important people, not only within Microsoft, but also within other companies.
I would say my favorite part about the BAMYC Mentees program is that I got to meet new people, meet my group mentors, my personal mentors, got to meet my classmates.
As a whole, I really enjoyed the fact that I got to talk to professional people, because it really broadened my view to like what the workplace is actually like and how people actually, you know, talk and do things, and even like certain terms that they use that I would have never guessed they use because it's such a niche thing.
What I enjoyed most about the program was definitely being able to meet and connect with a bunch of new people. Through this program, I've met amazing people and I formed a few strong bonds with some of the people I've met.
Sounds like you really enjoyed the program. That's great, and I agree with the career jumping. They do a lot of it. Next question. What is one thing that you would like to see added or improved about the BAM NY Summer Mentorship Program?
Well, I think a lot of it was different this year because it was online. I would say, like, maybe when it's in person, maybe it would be interesting if you were given the opportunity to, like, shadow someone.
Okay. So, of this mentorship program, and also they are such incredible people, and
more introduction to people, or like even stuff from like the software, the technical side of things. Well, there was that one chat with software engineers.
Maybe it's like an intermediate, because there's a lot of people in the beginner class and not very in the advanced. So have something like more structured to the coding.
Yeah, I agree with that too.
One thing that surprised me is, I guess, the amount of people that were willing to meet with us. Like, I didn't know there were, like, that tons of people that just wanted to talk with us. Like, it's mind-boggling, right? And these people were actually willing to network with us as well, because, like, that's something I just didn't know, you know?
Those who don't know coding aren't really getting that much out of it besides like service level exposure.
But another thing I would like to share to you is so I hear that you do have fun with interviewing guests and stuff. Do they answer back any of your questions?
Yeah, nice to meet you all. My name is Sydney, and I had probably a little bit more of an untraditional path into like a tech adjacent role. I went to college, the University of Maryland, for psychology and Black women studies.
Hi, my name is Eladio Martin. I go to Brooklyn Prospects, and I live in Brooklyn, New York, and I'm 16. I'm a rising junior.
Come for me and where I am today, and then what factors drove the decisions that I make today. So the question I want you all to consider is, you know, are you prepared for those pivotal moments in your life?
Like here. Here, essentially using different, well, I'll print it out here, and I'll, everybody else also try it as well. Let me know if you don't want to attempt it, but.
After doing some research, I discovered that you're a senior risk manager at Microsoft. So given that, you have to be aware of any outcomes that Microsoft can be exposed to. So given that responsibility, along with any others you may have, what exactly is your strategy for finding solutions to avoid any risks? And what skills did you acquire to do so?
So, you know, I think even on the global scale and in that world, you know, are we making sure that we're planning beyond, like I said, just a couple of months, but going, you know, holistically? So
I run an organization that has about 7,000 people. And so, you know, personally, I'm not the one who's doing the work to create the Xbox, you know, Series X video that unveils the Series X. And it doesn't get a lot of attention, but it's literally changing the way we spend money with our own supply chain.
I didn't exactly get that same experience online. We didn't even really have an orientation before school started. But I would say, like, reaching out to other people who, you know, may be going, you're all in the same boat, so you don't really have a lot to worry about. But I'm sure, like, you know, choosing a great school, they'll definitely be helpful in helping you make that transition.
I actually recommend doing that. I would say, like, doing a list inside of a list, that is not like a rare.
Very employee-led community aimed at creating an inclusive Microsoft culture where Asian employees feel equitably seen, heard, and supported so that they can thrive personally and professionally.
Progressively, I mean, this is in the 80s, 90s, and so on, early 2000s. I think progressively, people are being more accepting and more understanding and more inclusive. And that's what we're promoting, right? It's diversity and inclusion.
I want to say thank you. This is the New York team. This is everybody that's part of our program. You don't see them. They're all behind the scenes. They're all doing different work.
When you have more confidence, you are a better leader. So I think those things all come together. For me, leadership is also about never asking someone to do something you wouldn't do yourself. So when you're in it with people, you know, when you're in it with the team, when you're willing to roll up your sleeves and really understand people's problems and understand what they're trying to solve for, you are a better leader as well. So I think it's a combination of just knowing people and being willing to learn about how different people and different experiences show up.
Highlight as well. So I'm gonna go counterclockwise, if you will. We're gonna go back the same way, and I want you to start with Francina.
In terms of what advice I would give my younger self, to be quite honest, I think I would give more advice to my adult self than my younger self, because I feel like my younger self was a little bit more adventurous and tried new things and would like switch things really quickly, and I think that I would keep that as a thing.
When I started working with Latin America, it's kind of easier. I felt like I could navigate that easily.
To learn about this conversation, remember this. Remember this. You are responsible for yourself. And a big part of that is making yourself great. And that responsibility is anchored in what you're willing to learn. And your willingness to learn is anchored in your willingness to try and not succeed. Because what everybody teaches you, you can absorb. But what you are responsible for in yourself is to learn. That's very different than responsible for being taught. Because I promise you, the more you try, the stronger you will become. And by definition, the more you try, the more you likely will fail. And the more you try, plenty enough, the more likely you will be to succeed. And at your age, if I can push for anything, your willingness to learn And then by definition, I gave you what learning means. It's not just being taught.